I've been thinking it must be strange too for you when you're talking like this to think of who the audience is, you know, because the audience isn't.
Well, I don't think of who the audience is.
Yeah, right.
To me, it's just like a dance.
Right.
And, you know, it's whether or not the partner I'm dancing with is actual or virtual, it doesn't matter.
You're easy to dance with.
Still, the energy's there, you know. I might be right. Dancing with myself in a mirror or not, but that's just conceptual.
Right, yeah.
I have no idea. I don't think the audience is not a factor.
So you're just watching your karma sort of unfold in the way it is.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Just being me.
Right.
Is there room for self-reflection there? Does
certainly. Certainly. What do you mean by room?
Is that part of the more and other?
Well, of course it is. If it shows up, then it must be.
Well, but
the trick is
having left the station.
I'm sorry, I lost the context. I was a little. I'm sure I talked about it, but I don't know what in what context.
I don't know where that was. Didn't mean to interrupt you. I'll come back.
No, it's not interrupting. Everything that happens, but nothing is what it seems to be. That's the more another. So self-reflection happens, but it's not actually a self, and it's not actually a reflection. All phenomena, you know, psychological phenomena, subjective phenomena on any level occur, but in their occurrence, they're not what they seem to be, to the extent they seem to be anything in particular.
You don't buy into it, right?
Well, whether or not you buy into it, it isn't that, and if you do buy into it, what you're buying into is not what it actually is. Because what it actually is not buyable into. Buy-intuable.
It's just thought.
Buyable, intuable.
You had it right the first time.
Buy-intuable.
Well.
Fungible.
Well, what I'm thinking about the development of belief in a sense of self.
Right.
Which gets fortified with an interior dialogue, mm-hmm. which continues to create a world.
Right.
And I don't know, I'm thinking about it because of this damn camera. And
the camera isn't what it seems to be.
This mission is too important for me to allow you to jeopardize it.
I don't know what you're talking about, Hal.
Right.
Neither are your thoughts about it.
Exactly. And it's like, I look at, well, why do I care?
Yeah.
And what is that? You know, it's like it's maintaining a persona.
Right.
And identification and...
Right. So there's this persona there, there's this maintaining of identification, there's these opinions, there's all these things, there's these phenomena that are floating around in experience. Where do they come from? What are they made of? What's doing them? What are they actually? Are they actually just that? I mean, how do you have just a persona? What's a persona look like? You know, what seems to be a persona is actually something very strange that is... What is it? Answer that question. What is persona? You know, it doesn't need to not exist to be very different than you may think it to be. And what things seem to be, I mean, the whole essential mechanism of, you know, buying into things per se means taking them to be a certain way. And of course, they aren't that way because they're more another, as we can take formulaically, or actually see for ourselves, self-verifyingly, more powerfully. And then you see there's nothing to buy into. And if you're buying into a partial version of it, you're buying into a fiction, you're buying into a fantasy.
Yeah, they're just thoughts.
Yeah.
They're just thoughts about.
Sure. The thoughts. Yeah, sure. The thoughts and no thought is actually about anything, because thought isn't that. Thought is just an energy apparition in consciousness, like all phenomena are. But yeah, self-reflection can happen, you know, sense of persona can happen, identification with personality can happen, you know, projecting fantastical pasts and futures and getting emotionally entangled in them can happen. All these phenomena can happen, but when all that happens, nothing particular is happening. It's all just radiant presence. It's all just the flow of transcendental apparition in transcendental experience, or called transcendental consciousness. And if you look at it, you will see that fact, because that's what there is to be seen. There's nothing else actually there to be seen, which solves all problems in terms of getting sucked into any of these things as actually mattering. I mean, all these sorts of things will continually appear, endlessly. You know, thoughts will appear, opinions will appear, emotions will appear, all these things just never-endingly, you know, cascade through consciousness, through experience, right? But that's it. They're coming, it's coming, it's coming, it's coming. It's going, it's going, it's going. Everything is actually like that.
So that's
the
train
of visionists. You know, and that, there's a train.
There's a train. There goes another train. Just go down the subway, you'll see.
They don't actually never stop at the station. They're like, here it comes.
Here
comes. So I mean, all these tricks of spiritual practice and noticing and blah blah blah, it's all, you know, it's all a red herring. It's all bullshit. It's basically not actually like that. And yet, it can be useful to play with that if it is.
Yeah.
And so noticing is a trick. It's a red herring.
Yeah.
You know, you do noticing and you think you're doing something. Oh, great! I'm doing something. That's great. And after a while, you get, wait a minute. This is like a snipe hunt. The joke's on me. This is always noticing, and that's what realization looks like.